Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. My name is Martin Y, an aerospace engineer living in Kentucky, US. If you are thinking to buy a new laptop and you're a fan of the compact and thin design, then you're most probably looking for an ultrabook. So in this video, I'm going to show you some of the best ultrabooks on the market so you can make your informed choice. I don't know if you actually know, but ultrabook is actually not a type of laptop, but it is a marketing term. And this was trademarked by Intel back in 2011, where they created specific requirements for certain number of laptops that are ultra thin, but in the same time extremely powerful. And so before digging into what are the best ultrabooks on the market, let's first talk what are the requirements for an ultrabook laptop. So since 2011, obviously the laptops improved quite a lot, but back then an ultrabook laptop would be thick 21 millimeters, it would have about 5 hours of battery life, and it should be able to resume from sleep for about 7 seconds. So back in 2011, the requirement for ultrabook was a thickness of 20 millimeters, a battery life of about 5 hours, and also a laptop that is an ultrabook should be able to resume from a sleep mode in about 7 seconds. Obviously, this improved quite a lot throughout the years, and today an ultrabook laptop should be with about the same thickness, 20 millimeters, but it also should have at least 9 hours of battery life and be able to resume from sleep mode in about 3 seconds. So all the laptops that I will talk about today will have all these features. We're looking at ultra thin laptops that have very long battery life and also can resume from sleep mode quite fast. I would actually add even few more requirements which are going to concern the weight of the laptop and the size. So we're going to look for laptops under 1.5 kilograms and we're looking at 13 inches screen. So we're really talking about very compact but quite powerful laptops with very long battery life. So the first laptop I will talk about in this video is the Lenovo ThinkPad X1, and I actually know this laptop quite good because I used it about 2 weeks ago, and trust me, it is really really thin and it has a very nice matte dark cover. So this is a Windows laptop with an Intel i7 chip, and it is actually the best laptop of choice for many companies just because of its reliability. It has 13.3 inches display and a function called always responsiveness, which means that it doesn't matter whether the laptop is on or off. Once you press a button, the laptop turns on instantly, so you don't need to wait, and also your applications are already loaded there. I know that this is a feature of many other laptops actually, even the MacBook Air that I currently have here has that feature as well, but it is of course very important to mention it because not all of the ultrabooks have this option as well. So the starting price of this laptop is about $1,000, actually to be exact $1,055, and for that money you are getting 11th generation Intel Core i5 processor, 8GB of RAM and 256GB of SSD, which is in my opinion very 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 low. Especially the i5 processor, I would say it is not that powerful, but I would say for this laptop this processor is very well integrated with the rest of the components. However, if I would ever purchase the X1 Nano laptop, I would definitely get the advanced version with probably i7 processor and more SSD. You're also getting an HD display and integrated graphics here, which is quite good, but actually there is a reason why I mentioned this laptop first. It is just because there are also way better laptops in these rankings as well, which I'm going to talk about later on, but this is quite a good start, and this laptop I would say for an Intel laptop is quite a good value for your money, so you should definitely consider it. Unless you don't get it from some company, if you already work there, in that case you basically don't have a choice. The next laptop I will talk about is actually a laptop that I talk quite often in my computer videos. This is the Dell XPS 13, and you shouldn't be surprised that I talk about this laptop so often. It is just because it is very good. I would say that this is the best Windows laptop on the market for sure, and if you just look at the frame, it's a mix between a carbon fiber and metal, and the thickness of that laptop is from 9 millimeters on the front to 15 millimeters on the back, which is way less than the 20 millimeters requirement from Ultrabook. So for that size, you are getting a lot of power, trust me, because some of the models of XPS 13 have the i7, even i9 Intel processor. And if you go a little bit bigger to XPS 15, you can also get dedicated graphics, which is way better for gamers or video editors. So the price of that laptop is about the same to the previous one, but I would say the way that this laptop is built is way better, assuming the better keyboard and the better touchpad. Also, if you want to increase the power of your CPU to Intel Core i7 11th generation, you would pay about $300 more for a model that has 16 gigabytes of RAM and also 512 gigabytes of SSD. The best thing that I like about Dell is that you have a lot of options and a lot of choice for the requirements that you want to put to your laptop. For example, you can also choose your type of display and you can go to up to 4K display. This of course will increase the price of your laptop with about $500, and it's of course not necessary, but here you really have the choice. And actually the model that I would take is definitely with HD display, 512 gigabytes of RAM, 16 gigabytes of memory, and also 11th generation Intel chip, which will cost you about $1,300. That is, I must say, quite a good price for this configuration. So really consider Dell XPS 13 laptop, because if you also watch other YouTube videos, you will see that this is a very renowned laptop among the people that are professionals with using computers. On the third place in our rankings is the Asus ZenBook 13. And I did not talk about this laptop in the past, but in the past years, Asus did something quite incredible and developed this really nice ZenBook laptop, which has the whooping 16 hours of battery life. It is actually thinner even than the XPS 13 laptop, and it has thickness of about 13.9 millimeters, while the weight is just above 1 kilogram. This definitely includes this laptop in our Ultrabook family. We can say that the ZenBook is quite compact with this size. Also, another thing that really impressed me about the ZenBook is the battery life. So the battery life here is about 16 hours, which is quite incredible. And if you're a student or a working professional, you really don't need to think about charging your laptop for about 2 working days. If you are not using, of course, a heavy software, which is actually the downside of all the Windows laptops, because when you use heavy software, they require quite a lot of power. But don't worry, later in this video, I will show you a laptop that can use less power even with that heavy softwares installed inside it. So with the ZenBook, you are actually getting one additional feature that none of the laptops in this ranking has, and this is the virtual keyboard that you are getting on your keypad. Yes, this laptop has actually a touchscreen keypad, so you can create a mode in which a numbers can appear on your keypad, and you can use it as a calculator or to type quite fast mathematical equations or simply estimate your daily bills. You can actually find this laptop for very cheap, and this is probably one of the cheapest laptops, and this was the reason why I showed it to you, specifically for people on low budget. So if you want to get the Intel i7 configuration of this laptop, you would pay only about $900. So for those money, according to Amazon, you would get a laptop with i7 processor, 8 gigabytes of RAM and 512 gigabytes of SSD, which are incredible specs only for $900. And even more insane is the price of the Ultra HD version of that laptop, which is only about $10 more expensive comparing to the OLED version. So really, especially if you're on low budget, under $1,000 for example, if you're a university student and you really want to save for books or for parties for example, you can definitely take this laptop for only $900 and enjoy all the Ultrabook features and use it as your main machine for your projects, assignments and so on. On the fourth place in the ranking is actually a laptop that I know quite a lot about, and this is actually the laptop that is now in front of you, the laptop that I own, and it's obviously my favorite one. this is the MacBook Air M1. In my opinion personally, this is the best laptop that the money can buy. You can have different opinion from me if you want, but I really believe that this is the best you can find on the market. This laptop is actually on the edge of being considered an ultrabook because its thickness is 20 millimeters. But don't worry, even though it is slightly thicker comparing to the other laptops in that category, the power that you can get from the MacBook Air M1 is outstanding. For $999 and for $899 for student, you can actually get this laptop with 8GB of RAM, 256GB of SSD, and the incredible M1 processor. And why I say incredible, this is because the M1 processor is completely new technology when you compare it to Intel. This is because it is way more powerful, I would say twice as powerful comparing to the i5 processor, for example, which is placed on the laptops that are the same price as the MacBook Air M1. And this laptop never stucks. It can run very heavy applications just on a battery, so you don't need to charge it all the time if you run, for example, engineering softwares or video editing softwares, playing heavy games and all that stuff. So I would say this ultrabook is quite a good value for the money. And plus the fact that this laptop doesn't have a fan, so you basically don't hear any noise, this makes it, in my opinion, the perfect laptop for every student or professional. Of course, if you're not a fan to the Apple operating system, iOS, of course you can refer to the rest of the laptops in that video and take a look at them. What I don't like about the MacBook Air M1 is the fact that if you want to increase your storage and your RAM, you would pay quite more comparing to the base model, because you would pay about $200 for every upgrade that you do. For example, if I select 16GB of memory, the price increases with $200, and if I want the 2TB SSD storage, for example, the price would increase with $800 more, so you would end up paying about $8,000 for this laptop if you want the maximum SSD and RAM built on it. And finally, the last laptop I'm going to talk about is a laptop that was released this year, and this is the Microsoft Surface Laptop 4. This is the last generation of the Microsoft Surface laptops, and I've used a third version of that computer and it was working quite well. I would say it had an overheating issues at that time, but I think today the Microsoft engineers worked really hard for a few years to make to perfection the Microsoft Surface Laptop 4. So you can get the base version of this computer for the outstanding $999 if you purchase it from the Microsoft website. And for that money, you can get it with the AMD Ryzen processor, 800GB of RAM and 256GB of SSD. And trust me, even though this is the cheapest version, for example, if I compare, the Intel models are way more expensive. Let me tell you that actually the AMD Ryzen processor is way better comparing to the Intel one, so don't feel regrets if you want to get the cheapest version. So this laptop is actually quite thin. It is only 14.7 millimeters, which definitely places it in the ultrabook category. The screen has its own resolution actually, and is 2256 to 1504, which is quite a worse resolution, but I guess they were trying to save some space and remove all the bezels on the side of that laptop. So for that reason, even though the resolution is quite weird, you can definitely say that they made the screen as big as the size of the actual laptop. So you should definitely consider purchasing the Surface Laptop 4 because it's really the newest version, and I think this laptop is the best one that the Microsoft are currently producing. But be careful, because I noticed the warranty of that machine is only about 1 year, which is quite weird because most of the computers out there have about 2 years warranty. I don't know why from the Microsoft they decided to put only 1 year. Maybe there is something wrong with their hardware, but I can definitely not say anything about that. So that were my favorites, ultra books guys, that I wanted to share with you. And let me know down in the comments which one is your favorite and if you actually own some of those incredible machines. On the other side, if that video helped you to make your own choice on which laptop to buy, definitely subscribe this channel, because let me tell you something, this is completely free and helps enormously to creators like me to make more interesting content for you guys. That said, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.